skilled in Afghanistan. He was 54 years ago on the 31st of August. He was 24 years old. Since his death, another 12 British soldiers have been killed, roughly averaging one every 4 days, and there will never have any Afghanis have died in that time. I have great sorrow and also anger at Kevin's death. It's not directed at the people of Afghanistan. My anger is towards the current and present governments of Britain and the United States of America. The Afghani people are only doing what anyone would do on being invaded. They are defending themselves. My concern was a young man whose admission was to be in the military. When he was younger, he often accompanied me on supporting the campaign for nuclear disarmament. He was in the army because he could see no future for himself in civilian life. So I doubt that there was much future as a soldier. But I know that with a decent education and a country run by honest politicians, he and many others would be given a chance to fulfill their dreams by the military. Please understand, most of the young men who are in the service are running against the people of Afghanistan. They consider themselves to be there to protect those serving alongside them. And they also ask the same question we did, why, what would you do? Definitely silence is usually the answer. I want people to stop the killing of all good in Afghanistan. These killings of civilian and military are premeditated murders. An infamous killer in the United States said there have been no apologies for premeditated murder. So Mr. Brown, your letter saying sorry to the refund just doesn't work. Our troops must be brought home now, on their feet, not on stretchers or in coffins. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed, Charlie, for that rather moving speech. And now we're pleased to be joined by Jenny Hurl from Falmouth in Cornwall, whose nephew, Callum Dean, is serving Abu Street in Afghanistan with the Coldstream Guards. Jenny.
Speaker, I'm not a famous person, I'm just representing, I'm a mother, an ordinary mother. I haven't prepared a speech because I didn't know I'd be speaking today. This man deserves a Victoria Cross for what he's doing. And if he goes into prison, I will go there with my gun and I'm sure that you put him there. And Callum is over there now, he's been out there 3 weeks. Somebody in his battalion, the latest soldier that was killed by a suicide bomber, this is what really, really frightens me. It went off 300 yards outside Camp Bastion, where they're supposed to be safe. They're getting closer. Bring them home for Christmas.